75% of dog owners will encounter a aggressive dog whenever they're out walking their dog. Hey guys, welcome back to our channel. I'm Jen and this is Farabee, and today I want to talk to you about how you can keep yourself and your service dog safe. Whenever I was doing research for this, I actually found out that 75% of dog owners will encounter a aggressive dog whenever they're out walking their dog. Up until then, I really thought it was just the service dog community that was encountering all these wild and crazy dogs, but apparently it's 75% of all dog owners. So that was eye-opening and pretty scary. So I wanted to talk to you about my favorite weapons. These are all non-lethal weapons. We're not going to talk about anything that would be life-altering for the long term for anyone. We're just going to talk about things that would be a quick way to help you protect yourself and get away from a scary situation. So something to keep in mind, I am in the US and I am an adult. So all of the stuff we're talking about is legal for me to have. Everything I'm going to talk about, I'll tell you the guidelines for what I found, but you need to do your own research and just make sure you're staying in compliance with your state. I'll tell you my findings, but obviously before you purchase anything, just make sure you're staying in compliance, especially if you're under 18. So the first thing we're going to talk about is pepper spray. So pepper spray is something that is legal in all 50 states. Most states you can carry it if you are under 18, but like I said, definitely check your local laws to make sure that you are staying in compliance. But we have two different types we're going to talk about today. And the first one we're going to talk about is the Saber. It's just a pepper spray that looks like this. You can get this in a dog strength, a regular strength, and a bear strength. We just have the regular strength. The dog strength is actually less. Nope, Fairby wants the handle. The dog strength is actually less strong than the regular one. But personally, I would just prefer to use this one in case there was a person that I had to defend myself against too. So this is the first one. And this is about $12. I'll link it below for you guys. So this type of pepper spray, you do need to be within about 10 feet of whatever you're trying to spray. And also this kind, it even says on the container for this particular kind that you need to shield your eyes if it's windy out because it can blow back on you. So this is not my favorite one to use. This is one that I just keep in a pocket just in case, you know, in case I forget my real one, basically. This stays in one of my pockets. But this is not my favorite kind. So my favorite kind is this. And this is a pepper spray. I know it looks like it's a little gun, and it is a pepper gun. But this is a pepper blaster by Kimber. And it comes in two colors. It comes in black or red. And the way that this works, there's actually two canisters of pepper spray here, and this is a blaster. The way this works is it does have a safety right here. And whenever you put your finger through here, it just moves really, not super, super easy, but with a little force it moves. And then your finger would just go in there and you'd pull the trigger. We're not gonna do that today, obviously. This is a gel, so it is going to stream. So you have a little bit of a longer distance on this, and that's pretty cool. This one is about $42 on Amazon. I'll link it below for you guys. This is definitely my favorite one just because it does have that gel, so you have a lot less chance of blowback, and also you have, you know, a lot longer range. So at least 2 feet, but obviously, you know, you can go much further than that. So the next thing we're going to talk about is stun guns and tasers. So these are legal in all 50 states except for Hawaii and Rhode Island. But there are different types of rules and regulations for them depending on what state you're in. Some states don't have any rules, but some states want you to have a carry permit just like you would for a gun. So I have a stun gun, and this is the Saber 3-in-1 safety tool. And what this has a stun gun, and then it also has an alarm. And the alarm, you can hear it from 500 feet away. So that's really awesome. It's far enough away for, you know, for you to get a lot of attention. It's very, very loud if you're close up. The difference between a stun gun and a taser, a stun gun, it actually just has a current that runs between here, where a taser has a actual little metal cord thing that shoots out a certain amount of feet, and it attaches into, you know, whoever you're needing to tase. So a lot of tasers also have a stun gun feature built in. So if you pop the taser portion out and like you miss for some reason, you miss the person that's attacking you or the dog that's attacking you, you would still have a feature where it is a stun gun. But it, you know, to use a stun gun, you have to actually make contact with something. Otherwise, it's just a lot of loud noise going on. And that has worked actually in our favor. like I said, this is just a stun gun. This is not a taser. So the stun gun, what I've had to do a few times whenever we were being run up on by dogs that had their head lowered and hair on their back raised and I wasn't sure what was going to happen, I was able to just pop this and hold it down. And because of how loud it is, it made the dogs back off. So that worked out really well in our favor. Obviously, I do have mace as a backup. It's $25. This comes in a few different colors. It comes in gray, obviously the pink and black, and then I think it comes in like a teal color as well. So this has been a really good tool. It is rechargeable. There is a on and off switch for safety reasons. So I like this a lot. But like I said, this is not a taser. So you do have to actually make contact and be like up on something to use this. But you know, it is a really good option. If you're interested in just having a personal alarm, they do sell a personal alarm as well. So another thing I have for safety is an action cam. And this is not gonna like necessarily keep you safe by any means. But the reason I have this is because one of the times that I've had to use the stun gun, pop it at something, there was a dog owner that was somewhat nearby and they got really, really pissed at me for doing that. I didn't make contact with their dog, but they went and like said that I had hit their dog and done all kinds of stuff when in fact I hadn't. But even if I had have done that, it would have been within my rights because we do have a leash law in my state. And that means no dogs are allowed off leash. And obviously if one is running at you and trying to attack you, then clearly you can defend yourself. This is not a GoPro. This is a knockoff of a GoPro and it is just an action cam. It's by Cam Park. I will link it below for you guys. This was about $40. It might've been about $45 actually, but it comes with a ton of accessories. You can clip this on your service dog's vest. You can obviously put it on yourself somewhere. There's all types of accessories that come with it in the box. So you can, you know, you can attach it to all different types of things. It comes with two batteries, so you can always have one charged. The batteries only last about 3 hours though, so that's not a super long time, but you know, obviously if you charge them both up, you can have 6 hours of battery power. The biggest thing I would say on this is if you're going to get one of these, definitely invest in a bigger memory card. You are saving money by getting a knockoff action cam instead of spending the money on a GoPro. So spend the money on having a bigger memory card so you can store more at once. This might be just extra paranoid level of safety, but I think it's worth it. So I hope this has been helpful information for you guys. Definitely just stay safe out there and make sure you have a way to protect yourself. The other thing I found that was cool is Saber makes something for people who, I guess for women who frequently go out, you know, out places where they might have an open drink. This doesn't have to be bars. You could even go to, you know, like a regular restaurant and just have your drink open. But they make these things that you can actually put in your drink to see if anyone's put anything like, you know, a date rape drug or anything in there. And so I'll link those below too. Obviously that is not necessarily for service dog needs, but I did think that was a neat thing to have. So I'll link that below too, since we're on the topic of safety. I know a lot of service dog handlers who watch my channel particularly are women, so I think that's another important thing for us to talk about. So I'll link that for you guys too. I will link one of our most recent videos up here. I will link a service dog playlist here and you can subscribe up here. Bye guys.